We both picked out the scene under the bed.
Yeah.
And we both knew instantly how impactful it was going to be.
Yeah.
There is something that feels like a proper gut punch.
The first time I got to read the whole of Six in its entirety, I was blown away by it.
The bond is really strong between them, and I think that's what you want, isn't it? It's a complicated love story.
Gosh. Oh, I love this outfit. Oh, it's such a beautiful day. Oh, there's Kier! And boom, there she is. I do not know why that man brought her. It's so strange because it's like they're having this conversation in just their eyes.
But I understand how busy you are.
And how busy you are with Violet. She's like, what are you doing? Because like in that moment, you like robbed her of the ability to fully express how she feels. Sorry, I'm still angry. I'm still pissed. Rejection. But she handles it well.
What was it? Did his speech not go well?
His Majesty did not deliver a speech. He never got out of the carriage.
What do you mean he never got out?
His Majesty could not get out of the carriage.
Well, what happened? What did you do? He seemed quite fine when he left
here. He was not fine.
We've had a scene preceding this one. It seems almost like they've overcome.
Yeah.
And that George can finally accept Charlotte's love and that they're together. George then tries to go and deliver a speech to Parliament and fails.
George, it is me.
Oh, mate, I'm actually not going to be able to watch this.
I think you're going to have to.
Reynolds told me what happened. I am here.
There was something so powerful about wearing that, what should be such a sign of power, and crumpling under a bed, and the dichotomy between those two things. I remember looking down and feeling such shame. It's a realization of there is nothing to be done. I will be this. I am not enough.
For Charlotte as well, she's not seen him like this before. This is the first time she's seen him. And I think she's really confused how, you know, she'd steadied him before he'd gone and she thought that, you know, she was what he needed. And actually this is the moment the ball drops that it's so much bigger than her and it's actually bigger than him.
Yeah.
Which is really sad because there's nothing that either of them can really do.
You have half a husband, Charlotte. Half a life. I cannot give you the future that you deserve. Half a man, half a king, half a life.
If what we have is half, then we shall make it the very best half.
Half a husband. Mm. God.
I am your queen.
No, she doesn't have half husband.
And as long as I am so, I shall never leave your side. You are king.
God, man. I think maybe the most moving line in the entire show for me is when I say, I'm so sorry I didn't tell you the truth, and you say, he did. You said you were just George.
Mm.
I remember reading it in the car with you.
Yeah.
Do you remember?
Mm-hmm. And I think we both picked out the scene under the bed and we both knew instantly how impactful it was going to be.
Yeah.
Yeah, and how important it was going to be to the story and then how much we needed to work on it to get it like where it needed to be.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
I think it turned out pretty damn good.
But this is an amazing moment.
It is.
Because it's one of the very few moments of joy.
Total joy for the two of them.
For the two of them.
They were able to just have time to themselves.
But even so, it's still a secret. It's so dangerous, but I think that shows how much they love each other.
And they're finding such joy in the danger of that, and they don't care. It's beautiful.
We were never allowed, as Reynolds and Brimsley, never allowed to show any emotion whatsoever. Yeah. There were many times when I would read the script and I would go, on behalf of Reynolds or on behalf of Brimsley, I would want to cry.
It's all about doing the job.
Yeah.
So it's constantly treading that line on how far they can push it within their roles.
Excuse me, sir.
What are you doing rustling about out here? How dare you step away from your duties?
Oh, God, I remember watching Q do this. When it's all cut together like that, it's heartbreaking.
I mean, he is amazing in this scene.
And then it's back to doing the job.
I wonder how long Reynolds has been gone. No idea.
No idea. He just does this in one look.
George.
No, do not bother me in the sky.
It is me. It is your Charlotte. I have some news, George. Wonderful news. George?
My first reaction to this scene was one of real excitement and intrigue. I know Tom Verica, the director, had a really specific way that he wanted to shoot the scene, and that way was really creative.
We both did this entire scene.
We did this entire scene together.
Together.
Then you did it with Golda, and I did it with James.
And we also watched them every take.
Beforehand, and we're like,
yeah.
Oh no, now we've got to go and do it ourselves.
It feels like the entire season they're fighting the struggle. And there's this beautiful moment of surrender in this end bit. Oh, now you see, now I want to cry.
A scene that transcends time.
Come. Oh. Hide from the heavens.
Now I want to cry. Great.
I was a mess.
I was in pieces.
Charlotte.
It's startling how well the Georges match up.
Oh, totally. He finishes off
Corey's
performance so beautifully.
And this moment is absolutely stunning because it's this juxtaposition of like this juvenile place under the bed and these people who've been in this relationship for so long.
I'm so happy with how it was done. Their love is eternal. There's problems, but like it's still there.
I'm finished. I'm literally finished.
Yeah.
I've got goosebumps.
I'm glad she didn't go over the wall as well.
Yeah.
Tell you that much.
Thank you.
If one person goes away wanting to find out more about these two people, I think we've done our job. I want to thank the people of the world for watching this amazing, beautiful love story now streaming on Netflix.